So the newest version of Apple's iPhone operating system and iPad operating system, iOS 12.3, is now available for download. This is the iPhone 6, which is still my daily use phone, somehow. And so today we're going to be downloading iOS 12.3 onto this thing, so those of you who are still rocking the iPhone 6 can kind of get a feel of how the download process is going to go and some new features you can expect to see on this phone with this update and how exactly those are going to work. Now, based on the current rumors, this iPhone 6 will probably not be supported by iOS 13, so any iOS 12 update we're getting could be the last update for this thing, so this will be interesting to see, but let's go ahead and let's download it. Now, the main purpose of iOS 12.3 has to do with television, so you now have AirPlay 2 support on third-party television sets, which is quite interesting because this is stuff you traditionally needed an Apple TV hooked up to your TV to do, but it's nice to see they're making the option available to people who don't necessarily have an Apple TV but may just have another smart TV. There's also a redesign to the Apple TV app, which is nice because the current one is quite confusing and not very user-friendly. It sounds like a lot of the tweaks made here may make it a bit easier to use, which is nice. And other than that, there's just some miscellaneous interface tweaks to Apple's other subscription services, Apple News Plus and Apple Music, and your typical bug fixes you get with every update to make sure everything is running smoothly. It is only a 414.6 megabyte update, which is super nice, not too big. The only problem is we're facing this other bug that has plagued the last few software updates I've tried to do on this phone, which is this update requires a Wi-Fi network to download when I am very obviously connected to a Wi-Fi network. I'm not sure why it does this, but as per usual, I'm just going to have to play around and see if I can glitch it into installing, which kind of sounds weird, but that's what I have to do. I'm interested to see if anybody else has an iPhone 6 or any other iPhone that's exhibiting this specific problem. I want to know if it's like an iPhone 6 exclusive issue, or it's just my phone exclusive issue. Like, are other people getting this? I don't think it's anything wrong with my network, because my iPad is on the same network and does this perfectly fine, no problems. So yeah, I don't know, it's just a little weird. I'm going to try and get this to work. So a quick restart of my phone there, and then having to real quick press the button before it shaded out of existence. But it appears to be working now, and this is how I got it to work last time. So we will see what happens. Wi-Fi is loading. Like I said, I did have Wi-Fi connection, even though it said I didn't hear. It's really weird. I don't really know what is up with this issue. I'm really interested if anybody else has a phone exhibiting this. But here we go. About 20 minutes remaining. I'm going to time that on my watch and see how accurate it really is. So after only about a minute and 53 seconds, not even 2 minutes compared to the 20 estimated before, we're already on the preparing update section. For those of you who don't know, the time estimate you're given, which is always inaccurate, is only to the middle portion when the update's downloaded, then it has to prepare and install. So if you see an hour 48 minutes, which probably is not accurate anyway, it's not talking about the whole update, it's just talking about this part. But I did see this jump around a lot. After I put the camera down, we went up to 48 minutes and then back down to about 3, and ended up finishing in 2. So I guess it all just kind of depends on your internet conditions, which are constantly changing, but there's not much else on this network, so I'm really not sure why it felt the need to jump so much, but hey, whatever. After about 5 minutes and 35 seconds to be exact, we are ready for installation. Let's get this verified. Alright, it took 2.5 minutes just to boot into the installation process here, which it's still trying to do, but yeah, that whole verifying update thing always tends to take a very long time for me. I don't know if that's just a me thing, or if anybody else has that too. It didn't used to be like that. It may just be because it's an older device. I'm not quite sure, but we're into the installation now. So all in all, that took about 23 minutes to complete, which is a little longer than I expected. But all we really get here is this just little notification. Your iPhone has been updated to iOS 12.3, and of course we've got to put in our passcode after an update like this.
Now, unfortunately, I do not have an AirPlay 2 enabled third-party television, so I won't be able to test out the new AirPlay 2 functionality in iOS 12.3. However, we can jump into that new TV app.
So opening up the new Apple TV app for the first time here, and here we go. You can see there was a new logo there. I can talk about that more in a second, and I assume we'll get some kind of new splash screen here. Welcome to Apple TV, all your favorites all in one place.
I will say I haven't really used this device or this app very much at all, so there's not much going on here, but playback searches and blah 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 is all private, so that's interesting. Let's go ahead and start watching here, and that should pop us right in to our app. And so here we go. We got three tabs on the bottom. You have Watch Now, Library, and Search. Watch Now is kind of the same as it was before, except now you can choose movies, TV shows, sports, and kids as your categories from the top. And this will just kind of give you suggestions on what you might want to watch. None of this is really all that personalized, since I never really use this app at all. But it will be personalized if you use it a lot, and it'll tell you, for example, Peanuts in Space. It'll tell you what different softwares you can use to play it, that kind of thing. And I'm not being super informative here. Library, it's stuff you got. So this was from a long time ago, and this was purchased recently when I decided I might actually start using this app for something legitimate. And then you can search through the TV app for specific shows you may want to watch. So on the individual watch page for, say, a TV show like Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. here, you can see a synopsis of the most recent episode, and here you can see all the episodes listed, and from each season you can even pick a specific season from that dropdown. From here you can also see some related shows that you might be interested in that are related, the cast and crew, and then most usefully how you're going to be able to watch it. So for example, buy it from iTunes, get ABC or Hulu, and even tells you there which seasons are available with which service, which is pretty dang useful, I will admit. Much like Apple's App Store currently, it does show certain trending things. So we have trending movies and trending TV shows. So if we want to search for something, like Back to the Future, it is a little bit slow and laggy, but that may just be because I'm on an older device here. So we can click Back to the Future and pull that up, and it can tell you you can buy and rent it from iTunes, or can also subscribe to Cinemax, and even tells you the free trial period and how much a month it costs for said service to watch on, which is interesting, and you can see that more on the bottom here. So yeah, it's really neat how it all works. It's kind of nice, a really nice tool, I think, for someone that watches a lot of movies and TV shows. Again, that's not necessarily me. But if I did want to get into watching more movies and TV shows, this would be a nice way to do it, because it kind of shows you how you can get to different shows and things. It just seems like a pretty useful app, and it's been redone a little bit here. So I kind of glossed over this earlier, but the Apple TV app on the home screen now has a new logo. My camera is terrible at focusing, but instead of being just a TV screen like it was before, it has adjusted to a new blue Apple TV logo, literally just Apple TV logo. It's kind of a bluish, greenish type color to try and match the new Apple TV Plus streaming service aesthetic, because that's coming at some point soon, which will be interesting to see how that goes. I personally liked the old TV logo better, just because it matched everything else on the iOS home screen by looking like what it actually was. For example, the calculator is a calculator, and just having the logo there is a little bit weird, but, I mean, I'll get used to it and it'll be fine.
So surprisingly enough, I'm pretty sure that every iOS 12.3 feature, at least the ones that Apple was really hyped about telling us about, do all work and are available on the iPhone 6, which is awesome because this is a device that has really missed out on a lot of major iOS features in recent updates, so I'm kind of glad to see that we actually get everything this time around. So just wondering, are any of you guys still rocking the iPhone 6? And are you likely to upgrade if the iPhone 6 ends up not supporting iOS 13? Just kind of what's your opinion on that whole deal? And as usual, thank you guys a whole lot for watching, and let me know what kind of content you want to see on the channel in the future. I'll be continuing to use my iPhone 6 on a daily basis because it still works. See you later.